Welcome back, viewers, to another exciting episode of our tech series. Today, we'll be diving into the fascinating world of computer hardware and exploring the power-on self-test, or POST, which plays a crucial role in ensuring the smooth functioning of your computer. So, let's get started. The power-on self-test is an essential diagnostic process that takes place every time you turn on your computer. It is designed to check the vital components of your system and verify if they are functioning correctly. In this video, we'll be taking a closer look at how POST works, what it entails, and why it's important. When you press that power button, the POST is triggered. Its primary objective is to identify any potential hardware issues that may hinder your computer's startup process. POST is typically carried out by the computer's basic input, output system, BIOS, or Unified Extensible Firmware Interface, UEFI. The POST process can be divided into several key steps. Let's go through each one to get a better understanding. Power supply test. The first step is to ensure that the power supply is providing the necessary voltage to all components. POST verifies if the power supply is functioning correctly. CPU test. The CPU, or central processing unit, is the brain of your computer. POST checks if the CPU is properly seated and operational. Memory test. POST verifies the integrity of your computer's RAM, random access memory, modules. It checks for any errors or faults that may affect system stability. Video card test. The video card is responsible for displaying graphics on your monitor. POST tests the video card to ensure it's working correctly and properly connected. Peripheral test. This step involves checking all peripheral devices connected to your computer, such as keyboards, mice, and external storage devices. During the POST process, your computer may communicate any detected errors or issues through error codes or beep sounds. These codes or sounds act as diagnostic indicators, helping you identify the specific problem. Different BIOS manufacturers have their own unique error codes and beep sequences. Let's take a look at some common error messages you might encounter during POST. No bootable device found. This error indicates that the computer cannot find a bootable operating system. Memory parity error. This error suggests a problem with the RAM or the system's memory. CMOS battery failure. The CMOS battery powers the motherboard's memory for storing BIOS settings. If it fails, you might encounter this error. A comprehensive overview of the power-on self-test, POST. This essential diagnostic process ensures that your computer's vital components are functioning as they should, enabling a successful startup. Almost everything that might prevent the computer from continuing to boot will signal some kind of error. Errors can come in the form of flashing LEDs, audible beeps, or error messages on the display, all of which are technically called POST codes, beep codes, and on-screen power-on self-test error messages during POST and their associated beep codes. Continuous short beep. This typically indicates a problem with the power supply or the system's memory. Continuous long beep. This usually points to a problem with the system's memory or video card. One short beep. This indicates that the POST was successful and there are no immediate issues. One long beep followed by two or more short beeps. This signifies a video-related issue, such as a faulty graphics card or an improperly seated video cable. Two short beeps. This suggests a problem with the CMOS or BIOS settings. Three short beeps. This could indicate a problem with the system's RAM modules. Four short beeps. This points to a timer failure in the system. Five short beeps. This signifies a problem with the CPU or the motherboard. Six short beeps. This indicates a problem with the keyboard controller. Continuous beep patterns or non-standard beep codes. These can vary depending on the manufacturer and may require consulting the system or motherboard manual for specific troubleshooting guidance. Please note that beep codes can vary between manufacturers and BIOS versions, so it's always recommended to refer to the system or motherboard manual for precise information related to beep codes during POST. Thanks for watching my video. I try to make more video for you. If you like my video, please subscribe and share with your family and friends.